Hey guys, Seth Fuller, your favorite lawyer here. So today I got a call from a young lady who had been sexually abused as a child. When she was around the age of 8 years old, she was abused by an 11-year-old relative. Now, that's bad enough. But when she was a kid, she reported it to her parents and the parents addressed it within the family but never went to the police. And cut to 20 years later, 20 something years later, the relative in question is arrested for child pornography. Now, of course, this is devastating to her. There's guilt, there's feelings of responsibility. And so my number one job was to try to make her understand that none of this was her fault in any way. And even her parents, I think, don't deserve that blame. The people who sexually abuse children are the ones to blame. However, her main question is, well, what can I do? And usually I would say, go and press charges. But when I ask how old he was when he abused her, he was 11 years old. Now, this ties into a video I did last week. I'll post it here. But basically, if you're charged with murder at 10 years old, 11 years old, if you murdered someone at that age and then became an adult without getting caught and then it's later find out you were murdered, you could be charged as an adult at any time, no matter if you were between 10 and 15. However, in this case, continuous sexual abuse of a child, you have to be 15 years old to be charged with that as an adult. So there's like a forgiveness period. Now, this is crazy to me because in my opinion, you're much more likely to keep abusing someone than you are to keep murdering people. So I had to tell this young lady there's really nothing she could do on that part, but I encouraged her to become an advocate, to call the district attorney in charge of the county where the man was arrested in and talk to them about what happened. There are phases of punishment that stuff like that can come in. Whether it does or not, it's not up to her, but she can tell her story. Which brings me to the point today. If you're the victim of any abuse, report now. I don't do this as some sort of, every time I do this, talk about this, there's a weird backlash from the community that's kind of accusing me of being a victim blamer. That's not what I'm saying. I'm stating the facts, which is the earlier you report abuse, the more likely it is to be punished and for the person who abused you to be brought to justice. And bringing child abusers and sexual abusers to justice is absolutely critical, because this is one of the few crimes that begets itself, that produces more criminals. What I mean by that is, if you're the victim of a robbery, you're not going to turn around and rob somebody else because somebody robbed you. That's not usual. I'm sure it happens, but it's not usual. However, when children are sexually abused, they often act out on other children. And so you get this spreading, this almost like a vampire biting somebody and that person biting somebody. It doesn't always happen, but it does happen enough that it creates an exponential effect that we have to stop here and now. If you were abused as a child, you should report at any time. I don't care what age they were. Report, advocate. We now have social media where you can go talk to the other people around that person. Make sure there aren't any other victims lurking in the corners who have no voice. There are places, Friends of the Family, Children's Advocacy Center. I'll try to remember to put those in the comments. But these are places that you can go where you can feel safe and where you can talk to people who are experienced in this type of advocacy. But please don't wait. If you did wait, do it anyways. But please do not wait. Report it today. If you know of anything like that, I beg of you to go out and report it. You do not want to be this young lady. You do not want to be the person who was abused and then years later you find out that that abuser has other victims. Because again, no matter how much I tell you, I can't control the feelings you're going to likely have. It's a crazy world. Abuse does terrible things to people, and then abuse guilt is a real thing that affects people very seriously. So please contact one of these agencies, contact your local police, report and get help. Go seek counseling. And again, Friends of the Family, Children Advocacy Center, even if you're an adult, these places can direct you to the help you need. And usually you can get help free of charge, because there are people out there trying to help victims of sexual abuse, especially child victims of sexual abuse. So that's my message for today. If you know of any sexual abuse, report it today. Thank you for listening, and y'all have yourselves a good one.